Hi guys, welcome back to the React.js video tutorial, and in this video we are going to learn that how we can get the value from the input boxes and submit a form. So now let's get started. So first of all, I'm just going to show you, this is my normal HTML. I just put some HTML tags here, and now I'll write some code for state and a function that how we can get this data. Alright, so first of all, I'm just going to make a constructor. Alright, and in the constructor, I'm just going to define the super and state. Super for get the functionality from the parent component, and this dot state. And in this dot state, I'm just going to take the two states, which is a similar the name of the username and the password. Alright, so by default they are, let's say, blank. And alright, so by default they are blank, right? So now I'm just going to define a function here on click on change. Alright, and on the click on the on change, I'm just going to get the value and try to submit. So first of all, I'm just going to console a value here. So what I'm just getting, alright, so I'm just going to passing a event from here, and it will be just showing here in the event. Alright, so I know what I have to do, but I just want to demonstrate you that's actually what we will get in this. Alright, so I'm just going to press some button like A, then you will get the lots of text. Alright, so for that I just have to write here e dot target dot value. Alright, now let's try to what we will get here. Let's say ABC. So we got the text one by one, and we are not get anything here. Why we are not get anything here when we are just even try to push here? Because we are nothing in the state, right? And we are just using the on change function. Alright, so how we can get it now? For that we have to use the states. So I'm just going to use the state here like this dot state dot username. Alright, and here I can update this state. Alright, so I'm just going to use here this dot set state, and here just using a simple username, and here e dot target dot value. Alright, so let's break it in the underline so that you can understand it much better. Alright, so on the change function we just update a state here, and if you want to call a function here, then you can call a function and change the state inside here. But there is a maybe lots of fields, so for the every fields we cannot make the new function, so that I just update the state here. Alright, so now let's see. Now you can see that it's working, but in it is not still working. Same thing we have to do here also. Alright, so just I'm just going to copy from here and just pasting here, and the same thing with I'm just going to do with the values. Alright, so now here we have to use the password field. Alright, so on the submit button I'm just going to call a function, let's say on click, and in this on click function the function name is this I have to use the arrow function, this dot submit. Alright, so I'm just going to make a submit function here. In this submit function I'm just going to console dot warn this right here all data, so just print here this dot state. Alright, so now let's try to put some data with the name of like Peter, and the password is also some pass, and just try to click here, then you will get the old data here. So let's say you have a third field also. So I'm just going to take this field here. Alright, so this field is, let's say, email. So I'm just going to put the email inside the state here. Alright, and just make it email here also. And now you will, okay, so just make a little bit style. Okay, so now just let's say Peter. Some pass and Peter at dash.com. And now you will see that you got the old data here, and you can use this data as an sending in through the API. The next video we will learn that how we can send this data in the API. So thanks guys, thanks for watching this video. If you have any kind of confusion, you can ask me in the comment box. Don't forget to subscribe our channel.